Climate risks are now at the top of all global risks. The World Economic Forum ranks extreme weather events and climate action failure as the top two global risks over the next 5 to 10 years. And what is a risk to our planet and people is also a risk to business, with significant impacts on operations, revenue, expenses, and overall business strategy. So what are climate-related risks? There are two types of climate-related risks, physical and transition. Physical risks are the direct impact of climate change, such as severe flooding and heat waves, that can threaten human lives, infrastructure, and business activities. Impacts on business can include supply chain disruption and health impacts on workers. Transition risks are the result of global efforts to transition to a net zero economy, such as new climate policies, which can cause major impacts on business, such as market share losses or reputational damage. Risks are influenced by three main factors: hazard level, exposure, and vulnerability. First, consider what climate-related hazards are relevant to your business and how they may develop over time. Next, determine how exposed your business is to these hazards. And finally, assess how vulnerable your business is to such hazards. Once you have identified your climate-related risks, consider how best to mitigate and adapt to them. Conducting a risk assessment will bring three key benefits to your company. First, you will better understand climate-related risks, resulting in a better overall risk management strategy. Second, you will identify new business opportunities, such as low-carbon products and services. And finally, your business will be more attractive to investors and lenders by disclosing climate-related risks and opportunities. Climate change will result in major disruptions to all sectors of the economy. However, with these risks come new business potential. Climate business opportunities are valued at around $2 trillion. The potential value of these sustainable business opportunities is almost 7 times greater than the cost of realizing them. Financial companies are also forecasting around $1.2 trillion in potential revenue for low carbon products and services. A climate risk assessment consists of 4 steps. Number 1, identify the climate-related risks and opportunities that are relevant to your business. Second, use scenario analysis to project how these risks and opportunities may change over time. Number 3, develop a risk management strategy to mitigate and adapt to risks and opportunities. And finally, disclose risks and opportunities in alignment with the TCFD recommendations. This is the most widely used framework for assessing and disclosing climate-related risks. By measuring, managing, and disclosing climate-related risks, your company will be in a better position to mitigate and adapt to climate change, and to meet the growing demand for disclosing risks to your stakeholders. Kick off your climate action strategy now.